What is up, my friends? Back with another video today. And I just wanted to start this off by talking about the fact that I just passed 5,000 subscribers. I don't even know really what to say or where to start off this video. I certainly never expected my channel to actually gain some type of community. I've never thought of myself as an educator. I've never thought of myself as like an extrovert or putting myself out there for the world to see and, like, you know, broadcasting my opinions and, you know, just getting in front of a camera. I never expected this to be what it is right now. When I made that first video about how I sold my Nikon D850 and went over to the Z6, it was strictly for real content and information and strictly for the mindset of helping other people in my situation learn something that I was doing. It was not anything that I wanted to get to build a channel. It was not something I wanted people to, you know, a bunch of people to click on. The only intention of making that first video was me letting other people in the wedding industry know, hey, the Z6 is actually a very good camera. I use it. These are the reasons why I dumped my DSLR for it. And all of a sudden, we're here, you know, less than a year later, over 5,000 subscribers, and a community of people who actually interact with me on a really special level. Like, I have lots of conversations, and I've started to, like, build relationships with people through this channel that would just, like I met you guys normally throughout my course of my life. Like, there's less of a, like, an online separation between you guys. And I know that a lot of, you know, you guys are online and you guys are listening to me on YouTube, but it's hard to put into words how this feels. I don't think that people really understand what it's like for somebody to flip on the camera and start putting their views on life and, you know, photography and all the things that we talk about, putting it out there for the world to see. It's not an easy thing. And especially when you're coming from a place like I am where, you know, my life is my work. What I care about is creating real images and authentic images and having something that stands the test of time be produced by me. My work is not, you know, creating YouTube videos and, you know, I'm not a YouTuber. I guess I'm kind of assuming that role, but my number one thing is my photography. And to be in this position now where people are listening to me and coming to me with questions and asking me what they should do with photography and things like that is really a humbling thing. And I just want you guys to know how much I appreciate it and what it actually means to me. So, you know, a couple things about the channel in the future. All I want you guys to know is that I am not saying that any one of my viewpoints or anything that I put out here is gospel, that it's the 100% truth. I don't believe that I know everything, and I know that I'm always learning. I wanted this channel to sort of, you know, whenever I flip on the camera and make a video about something, it's all about me just saying, hey, here's the truth for me. This is the way I see the world or the way I see photography or whatever I'm talking about. And here's the honest truth from coming from my perspective. So do with it what you will. I never knock anybody for doing something differently or having a different perspective or using a different camera. I think it's all love to me, and I don't care as long as, you know, we have healthy discourse back and forth, and I love hearing other people's viewpoints. But I just want this to be a hub of authenticity. You know, in this field, in YouTube, it's very, very difficult. Now that I've started to make videos and I've actually built up this kind of, you know, community here, I see it's difficult for people to separate themselves. It's very easy to get into that trap of just making clickbait videos and, you know, talking about specific brands and trying to do things that create controversy, because it's super easy. If you want to build a YouTube channel, all you have to do is just do that or attack other people, because that gains some type of recognition and people talk and bicker and blah, blah, blah. And it's just, I'm not interested in that. I'm not interested in the bottom feeders of any community. I want the top tier, the thinkers, the people actually producing things, the people who actually want to learn. Those are the people that I think I'm attracted to this channel, and it makes me so fucking grateful, honestly, because it's just a lot of fun. You know, I've seen the best of people, and I have seen the worst of people on YouTube for sure, but majority, it's been very, very positive. So thank you guys for all the engagement. I'm trying to figure out exactly how I want to continue with this channel. It's a lot of work. I mean, it really is. It's a lot of work to constantly come up with fresh new content and, you know, try and stray away from the things that I know people will click on and do videos for that just because, you know, somebody will click on it. Rather, you know, I do want substance with what I'm saying here, and I want to keep it, you know, not driven by, like, as this channel grows, I don't want it to be driven by advertisers and things like that. Not that anything's inherently wrong about that. It's just I would prefer for this to be like a community supported channel, not something that is driven and I feel like I have to make for advertisers or, you know, advertising revenue or things like that. So I'm still trying to figure out how I'm going to do that. I know it's extremely hard to monetize the channel and keep it going that way, especially when, you know, I have all this other business and you know, work-related stuff that I have to take care of, that is a priority, but this channel is also becoming a priority too. So, you know, you guys are important to me, and putting out info for you guys is important. So I'm trying to find the balance and like how everything's gonna click together. But it's in the beginning. You guys are my first 5,000 subscribers, and you know, if you guys have any ideas on how I can start to manage this stuff, just let me know. But as always, thank you for all the emails and all the messages and everything that you guys have done throughout the past year. It's just really been an amazing experience and a lot of fun. So, you know, here's to the next. You know, I've had this channel for like 8 months or 10 months now, and so I'm really excited to see what the next 10 months bring, because future looks bright for this, because I think that people are starving for real authenticity, like not just people who talk the part, but people who are actually living it. Like, you can go to my website, you can go to my portfolio, you can go to my Instagram, you can see all the stuff that I'm actually doing, you can see I'm actually working, I'm being hired by actual clients, you can see my work and that it speaks for itself. I'm just somebody who's been out there working, who decided to try and give back through the things that I've learned. And I'm not, like I said, I'm not saying that this is all gospel truth and it's going to work for everybody, but at least, you know, for me, I feel like it's the truth for me. So thank you again. So today I wanted to do a quick video on just a technique. So I've been getting a lot of questions and a lot of emails about people trying to ask me what I do for reception lighting, and a lot of new people out there. Now, this is not going to be a technique that a lot of the really seasoned guys have not heard of. This is something that's kind of, you know, if you know your camera and you really know how to manipulate the settings and you're shooting a manual, you should be able to conceptualize this very easily. But I think this is a good technique, a very good technique, if you're just starting weddings, to get on the dance floor. Now, the best thing that you can do to make epic dance floor photos, to make ones that are really, really good, is to get on the dance floor. And I mean get in the dance floor. I mean, when there are people dancing in the receptions, you know, Sarah, I wish she was here because she can attest to this. I am literally in the middle of the dance floor. I'm down on my knees, I got the camera up, I'm in people's faces, I'm dancing, literally dancing with people. I mean, I am in the dance floor. And the reason why I do that is because there's certain things that you can't fake with a camera. You know, there's a lot of things you can manipulate and fake and make unreal from how they were, but you cannot fake the energy of somebody getting on the dance floor and photographing from that perspective. It's just, there's no other way to do it. Like I've said in another video, when I first started this, I second shot for a couple other professional photographers, and they had been doing this for a long time, and I just think they kind of lost their passion for it, because they would just stand on the outskirts and shoot with like an 85 or like a 50, a little bit longer lens, and just stay on the outskirts of the dance floor and just bounce the flash off the ceiling and go click, click, click from the outskirts. That always seemed like the dumbest idea to me, because you're not getting any energy. You can't really communicate what's going on the dance floor unless you're on the dance floor. So this technique will help you get out there. So once you get more comfortable, you can get a little more sophisticated with your lighting, setting up off-camera flashes and kind of, you know, starting to blend things and learning how it's, you know, backlight plus side light, things like that. But this is great to get out there and actually focus on the most important thing, which is the energy of the people. Now, I can't teach you, I can teach you all the camera settings and I can teach you exactly, like, you know, technically how I do it, but I can't teach you to scan, to get in there, to watch people as moments are about to unfold and get in there. That's gonna take time and practice on your end. But if you wanna do the stuff that I do with this technique, all you have to do is take your camera, okay? Now let's talk about the settings first. My shutter speed is set to 1/10 of a second, okay? So 1/10 of a second, very slow, okay? I set my aperture to between f4 and f5. Usually I start at f4 and then, you know, maybe go down to f5. Sometimes I'll go down even as low as to 7.1, but starting off between f4 and f5 is a good place. So your shutter speed is at 1/10 of a second, your aperture is at f4 to f5, and then your ISO, depending on the amount of lighting in the room, I always start at ISO 500, okay? So those are your settings, what you start with. 1/10 of a second on your shutter speed, aperture is at f4 to f5, and then your ISO is at 1/500, or just 500, okay? You put your flash on the top of your camera, right on the hot shoe, and point the bare flash right in front. Okay, so you have a camera, flash, bare flash, no modifier, pointed right at front, shutter 1/10, aperture f4 to f5, ISO at 500. What you do is you set the flash to 132. I always start there, no matter what I'm doing, I set it to 132. And go out on the dance floor and then basically just shoot. I set the focus point right to the middle plus like up a little bit where somebody's face would normally be, but it's right in the middle, and then up a few clicks, and then you go out on the dance floor and then you shoot people and move your camera around a little bit. Some people call this dragging the shutter on the dance floor. So basically you just take it, you just focus, move it, and shoot. Move it, shoot. Move it, shoot. Move it, shoot. And you can do different things with this. You can actually like kind of pan it as you're shooting. You can, you know, kind of turn it sideways to get some swirl effects. You can go in and out to a point, you know, not too much because you're gonna ruin the focus plane or focal plane. But basically what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be getting all that movement in the background with all the lights and all the other people and all that. It's gonna be like a movement, a swirl of lights. And then the flash is gonna freeze your subjects. Okay, so it's a really good technique because A, you don't have to set up any external flashes or any light stands or anything like that. Everything's contained to your camera. You're on the dance floor, which you need to be comfortable with. I'm gonna fucking hammer this so many other, anytime I do a reception lighting video, I'm gonna just hammer the fact that you need to be on the dance floor. I see so many photographers that just wanna shoot from the sidelines with a longer lens and the photos just are dry. Like they don't have any type of life to them. Like you have to get on there where people are going crazy and you will get that energy transferred to you. So slow down your shutter speed to get that blur in the background or get that motion in the background. Put the flash on 132, point the bare flash right at them, set your aperture at f4 to f5, and then, you know, you can play with your ISO. I like to start it at 500, but, you know, if it's too bright, obviously you can dial it down. You just use your ISO really is going to be for your ambient, because you want some ambient light in the background to kind of swirl it around. The stuff that's on the wall is going to add to a cool background, and then freezing that subject with the flash is going to make them pop out of it sharply. So that's a little tutorial, quick tip for you guys. I hope you guys can use it. I'm gonna be putting up some, as we're, you know, going through this, obviously I'm gonna be showing you guys sample images of stuff that I've shot with this method. And as always, please send me messages. If you guys have any questions on this stuff, drop it in the comments. You know, I appreciate the comments because it helps, you know, get the conversation going. I love the interaction, the community. So just please keep, you know, putting the comments on there. And, you know, if you guys have used this, drop in the comments, let me know. You know what I mean? Tell the new guys, hey, I use this, this works, this doesn't. And I think this is a really good technique that especially the new guys that are doing weddings can use. And it's a lot of fun because like I said, you guys get out there on the dance floor. So I appreciate all the feedback and thank you so much to all the new subscribers. You guys are fucking great. Anything you guys want to see me do a video on, tutorial, anything like that you'd like to learn from me, just drop it in the comments. And until the next video, my friends.